Welcome back to TenorShare, everyone. The iOS 17 beta is out, and I have been using it for hours now. It's great. Still, I don't think it is necessary for me to use this unstable version. I would like to go back to the stable version and wait. So today I will show you guys how to uninstall iOS 17 beta from your iPhone without data loss. Let's go! Before we start to downgrade, we need to backup our iPhone data first. Open the latest iTunes, click the backup option to create a local backup. If you have already backup before, you can skip this step. Once done, the next important thing is to turn off Find My iPhone in settings. Then we can proceed. Method 1, downgrade iOS 17 beta with ReiBoot. This is an expert iOS system repair tool, also contains a downgrade feature. Check the link in the description. Once installed ReiBoot, connect your iPhone to your PC or Mac and then open ReiBoot. On the home page, choose iOS upgrade and downgrade buttons, and choose downgrade. Now it need to download the iOS 16 firmware to downgrade your iPhone. Click download. Wait for the download to finish. It won't be taking long time. Once the download is okay, click the initiating downgrade option. Continue. ReiBoot will begin to downgrade your iPhone back to iOS 16. It could take a while, because they were two different generation systems. Be patient. When the process is done, you will need to set up your iPhone again. I will skip to the iCloud page. Here you can choose recover your data from iCloud if you have a backup. If you don't, just keep setting it up till you get to the home page. Okay, now your iPhone has gone back to the iOS 16. It's very simple and efficient. Go try it. If you like to use iTunes or Finder, follow the next method. To use iTunes or Finder, we need to go to ipswa.me website. Click iPhone, and choose your iPhone model. Then click the iOS 16 file, download it to your PC or Mac. This usually will take a while. Once the download is done, go back to iTunes or Finder. Press the Shift key and click the Restore iPhone option. Select the firmware you just downloaded and click Open. It says iTunes will erase and restore your phone to iOS 16. Choose the Restore button, then it will start to downgrade your iPhone to iOS 16. This will take a very long time, so I will skip it. Once the downgrade is okay, you will need to set up your iPhone again. If you have a backup on iCloud, you can restore it here. If you don't, just keep set up till you get to the home page. Now we can go to iTunes to get back our data. Since the backup we created on iOS 17 is not compatible with the official version of iOS 16.5, so we need to modify the backup so that we can restore it. Press WIN plus R key. Type %appdata% and hit OK. Now we are going to Apple Computer. Mobile Sync. If you don't see the backup folder here, please type in %userprofile% instead. Then go to Apple, Mobile Sync, open the backup folder. Choose the one we need or the latest one, and get inside the folder. Scroll down and find the info.plist file. Open it up with the notepad. Press Ctrl and F to launch the search tool, and search for the word product. Click Find Next. You will see the version of this data is 17.0. What we are going to do is change it to iOS 16.5 and save it. Then go back to your iPhone, and make sure Find My is still disabled at this point. Open iTunes and click on Restore Backup. Select the one we just modified. Click Restore. iTunes will start restoring all your data from the backup. When the restore is complete, we will see the hello screen again. Okay, now your iPhone is back to iOS 16 and all your iPhone data is still there. iOS 17 is great but still not that stable for common Apple users. Looking forward to Apple making iOS 17 greater. Hope this video is helpful to you guys. If you have any downgrade problems, please leave it to the comment. See you next time.